Hi everyone, Waluigi K here. I mentioned in my last video that I wanted to make a guilty pleasure gay movie list, so here we are. Now I want to stress that guilty pleasure does not necessarily mean that these movies are good or bad, but I find myself watching them because I just love them. Alright, first movie, Wedding Wars. This 2006 TV movie is a comedy that actually has a pretty stellar cast, with John Stamos, Eric Dane, Sean Mayer, Bonnie Somerville to name a few. The premise is that Shell is a gay wedding planner and his brother's wife Maggie insists that Shell does the wedding. Ben, however, is a speechwriter for the governor that's currently running for office. And if the gays on strike in the movie poster wasn't enough to tip you off, things don't exactly go well. As the wedding planning starts, a key point for the candidates becomes gay rights issues, something that refreshingly ties this goofy comedy to real-world events. When the governor comes out against gay marriage, Shell finds out that Ben was the one who wrote the speech. Again, to summarize, Shell decides to go on strike, hijinks ensue. There are two things that stand out in this movie for me. One, the fact that LGBTQ+ people really are everywhere and the alphabet/rainbow mafia should not be messed with. And two, the parallels to real-world events that are done quite well here. Without spoiling it, I really like the note the movie ends on. Okay, the next movie is All Over the Guy. This movie screams early 2000s and late 1990s. Again, some recognizable faces show up here too, like Dan Bukatinski, Sasha Alexander, Adam Goldberg, Richard Riculo, and even guest appearances and cameos by Lisa Kudrow and Christina Ricci. Now, in hindsight, when I think about this movie, I think, why do I like this movie so much when the gay leads are kind of toxic to each other? But I can't help it. A common theme with these movies is that there are a few pitfalls of dated gay cliches peppered in, but the stellar cast and story make it so enjoyable. See, the cliche here is the two straight friends try to get their respective GBFs to date each other. Although they do develop a relationship, the romance isn't exactly instantaneous. Both our gay leads confide in each other and progressively break down each other's walls. But man, those are jagged and rough. Still, there are some iconic lines and moments in this movie, so I do recommend it as a guilty pleasure. Finally, last but not least, Mambo Italiano. This movie cracks me up. I remember growing up catching this movie on cable sometimes, and I was so glad that I could watch the whole thing later. I was rewatching the beginning to get some ideas and footage for the video, and man, I love this movie. Now, if you want to talk about cliches and stereotypes, strap in for a mix of gay and Italian ones. Even though I think this one is hilarious and plays up the drama of being gay and, there are some pretty emotional moments in here too. The actors do such an amazing job because they instill that sense of familiarity to anyone who has to deal with being gay and insert blank. So all this gushing, what the heck is Mambo Italiano all about? Luke Kirby's Angelo reunites with an old friend of his, Nino, if you know what I mean, and has a bit of a crisis when he decides that he no longer wants to be in the closet, even though Nino wants to stay there, and Angelo's sister, who is hilarious in this movie, accidentally finds out. Again, infinitely quotable and funny moments galore, even amidst the dramatic moments. I debated putting all of these as all-time classics, but what ties them all together is that they're very entertaining gay flicks, even if they're a bit problematic in some respects. There you go! Three of my guilty pleasure gay movies. I honestly left some out to save for another video because I want to keep these videos short. I love talking about these and other LGBTQ+ media, so I'll definitely make more videos on the topic. I was also thinking of making a modern gay movie classics, so we can talk about movies from the last decade or so that I think deserve that title. And hey, if you like this video, why not like and subscribe and even leave a comment to let me know what LGBT movies you just can't help but rewatch. Until then, Waluigi K out!